as both Deming twins on his right, almost stolen away by McCutcheon, but picked up quickly by Bryson. Over to Braden. He waves off Owens, takes it himself down the lane, off the glass, good. The hoop, the harm, and he'll go to the line to try to make it a three-point play. Callahan O'Reilly called for the Hawks on the foul. So a beautiful first step there by Braden Deming. Very quick move straight to the basket. A nice floater off the glass. And his free throw counts. 11 points now for Deming, all in this second quarter. 31-19. Twelve-point lead. Hughes long three, no good. Misses it to the left. And Bryson Deming out to Braden. His three-pointer left-handed, no good. So still have yet to hit on a three from downtown. Is Billings West, 31-19, a minute 19 to go. And blocked out of there, nice block by Braden Deming. Owens in the corner. Tyson thinks about the three, now picks it up. Braden over to Bryson. Bryson up top to Peretti, he drives the lane, kicks it over to Tyson. Now up to Owens, he'll set it back up with 54 seconds to go here in a half. 31-19, Hawks still with a commanding 12-point lead. But West has come storming back. He only scored 4 points in the first quarter. 15 here. Down low, no good for Braden. That's his first miss of the second quarter, I believe. He's got 11. Hughes with it, 25 seconds to go. Hawks look like they're gonna be content to probably take the last shot here. Up by 12. Hughes to McCutcheon. To O'Reilly. Down low to Harlan, over the corner to Hughes. His long three, too hard. Tipped around and out of bounds. Last touched by McCutcheon. So with 3 seconds left, it goes back over to Billings West. See if they can cap this comeback here in the second quarter. 2 seconds to go. One half-court shot. Just too hard by Bryson Deming. And we'll go to the half break. 31-19 is our score. But it was 22-4 at the end of the first quarter. So West has made a big dent in it, but still down by 12. We'll take a 2-minute break, come back with first half stats. Once again, your score at halftime, 31-19. Hawks with the lead over Billings West. You're watching MTSport.TV.
Nelson Funeral Service, we are always incredibly humbled by the family feedback we receive.
You were very patient and went above and beyond our expectations.
It was apparent to our family that this is not just a job to you, but a calling and a mission.
Knowing that my dear husband was cared for so respectfully truly made a difficult time more bearable.
Doc and Nelson Funeral Service, there is a difference.
This live event is brought to you in part by Buckley Law Office, Bozeman Orthodontics, Platinum Property Management, Bridger Bubbles.
Napa, locally owned, means hometown pride.
Welcome to Napa Bozeman.
With over 100 years of combined experience behind every counter, we get it right the first time, making it easy for you to conquer the job, on the road, and in the community. Napa know-how means giving back, getting involved, and making our hometown a better place to live. Nationally known, locally owned, Napa Auto Parts.
Live event is brought to you in part by Buckley Law Office, Platinum Property Management, and Rocky Mountain Supply.
Your smile is an important part of who you are and how you project yourself to the world. Here at Bozeman Orthodontics, we get that. We understand that your life is busy and you don't have time for outdated techniques. We will always provide you with the latest state-of-the-art care from a specialist with over 7 years of exclusive orthodontic experience. So come in and let us help you live life smiling.
This live event is brought to you in part by Cashman Nursery, Davis Cabinetry, and Heeb's Grocery.
Welcome back to Bozeman High's South Gym as we have the Bozeman Hawk cheerleading team performing at halftime. 7:45 away from the start of the second half. Take a quick look at the stats. First for Billings West, they have struggled from the field, something that every team's done in Bozeman, shooting 37% in the first half. That's up from 16% at the quarter break. They are 9 of 24 from the field, 0 for 11 from the three-point line, and only 1 for 1. They've only gotten to the line one time compared to 14 times for the Hawks. Look at the scoring. It is all Demings, pretty much. 11 points for Braden Deming, all of those coming in the first, or the second quarter, excuse me. He's 5 of 11 from the field, 0 for 4 from the three-point line. Cade Tyson is 0 for 2, both of those coming for 3, so no points for him. 4 points for Bryson Deming on 2 for 5 shooting. He's 0 for 2 from the three-point line. And 4 points for Cleveland Harvey on 2 for 3 shooting. Jake Bell is 0 for 1 from the three-point line, and Jesse Owens is 0 for 1, also from the three-point line. So 4 points for Bryson Deming, 11 points for Braden Deming, and 4 points for Cleveland Harvey. So you can let one Deming score, but if you can shut down the other one, you're going to be in good shape. And so far, that's what the Hawks have done here in Bozeman this afternoon. 19 points on the night so far for Billings West. They have 2 offensive rebounds, 7 defensive rebounds, so 9 total. Personal fouls, they have 9 personal fouls. They have 3 assists on those 19 points and 6 turnovers. They had 5 turnovers in the first quarter, so they only had 1 in the second quarter, but still could only trim the lead to a 12-point lead. They have 3 steals on the night so far as well. For the Hawks, 4 points for Drew Hughes on 4 for 4 from the free throw line. He is 0 for 3 from the field, all of those 3-point shots, and none of them falling. 8 points on the night for Callahan O'Reilly. He is 3 of 6 from the field, 0 for 1 from the 3-point line, and 2 for 2 from the free throw line. 5 points for Bailey Harlan. He is 1 for 1 from the field, that being a 3-pointer, and 2 for 2 from the free throw line. 4 points for Morgan Hostetler on 1 for 3 shooting, 0 for 1 from the 3-point line, and 2 for 2 from the free throw line. 2 points for Mac Anderson on 1 for 1 from the field, and 8 points for Lance McCutcheon on 3 for 4 shooting, 0 for 1 from the 3-point line, and 2 for 4 from the free throw line. So neither team shooting well from outside. 0 for 11 again for the Billings West Golden Bears, and only 1 for 8 for the Bozeman High Hawks for 12% shooting from the 3-point line. But they are 12 of 14 from the free throw line for 86%. So huge, 12 points to only 1 point from the free throw line, and shooting 9 of 19 compared to 9 of 24 from the field, but one of those being a 3-pointer, and there is the big difference so far in this contest. The Hawks have 3 offensive rebounds, 13 defensive rebounds, so 16 total rebounds to 9 total rebounds for West. So the Hawks in a huge rebound advantage. Personal fouls, they have 5, 9 assists on those 9 baskets so far for the Hawks. 4 turnovers to 6 turnovers for Billings West. Bozeman High, 2 less, and 2 of those coming in the first quarter, 2 of them in the second quarter. And steals, they have 6 steals so far in the first quarter for the Hawks. So the Hawks dominant pretty much on all assets of this game, and that's why your score is 31-19. We'll take another 2-minute break. Come back with start of the second half and keys to how Billings West can get back in this one. Once again, your halftime score, 31-19. Hawks with the lead over Billings West. You're watching MTSport.tv.
Hi, Hi, I'm Kristen Hoyle. I've been a real estate broker in Bozeman for over 20 years. By being part of the number one company in Montana and joining our new brand, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Montana Properties, I'm able to offer my clients a new level of service. This year's proving to be a great year to buy and sell real estate. Call me. I'd love the opportunity to work for you.
Knowledgeable, strategic, dedicated. Kristen Hoyle, broker.
I'm Jerry Cashman.
And I'm Joe.
And I'm Mike Cashman.
Cashman Nursery supports the Bozeman School System and Hawk Sports.
Just as teamwork creates quality plants and landscaping,
so does high school sports help form teams into competitive students and successful athletes.
Go Hawks!
At Nelson Funeral Service, we are always incredibly humbled by the family feedback we receive.
You were very patient and went above and beyond our expectations.
It was apparent to our family that this is not just a job to you, but a calling and a mission.
Knowing that my dear husband was cared for so respectfully truly made a difficult time more bearable.
Doc and Nelson Funeral Service, there is a difference.
This live event is brought to you in part by J&V Restaurant Supply, Payne West Insurance, Perkins Restaurant, and Service Electric.
Napa, locally owned, means hometown pride.
Welcome to Napa Bozeman.
With over 100 years of combined experience behind every counter, we get it right the first time, making it easy for you to conquer the job, on the road, and in the community. Napa know-how means giving back, getting involved, and making our hometown a better place to live. Nationally known, locally owned, Napa Auto Parts.
Live event is brought to you in part by Slabworks of Montana, Town and Country Foods, and Western Drug.
Your smile is an important part of who you are and how you project yourself to the world. Here at Bozeman Orthodontics, we get that. We understand that your life is busy and you don't have time for outdated techniques. We will always provide you with the latest state-of-the-art care from a specialist with over 7 years of exclusive orthodontic experience. So come in and let us help you live life smiling.
Welcome back to Bozeman South Gym, 31-19. Your score, Hawks have led all of the way. Billings West made a good run in the second quarter, but could only cut it to a 12-point deficit going into the halftime break. Nice athleticism by the official bookkeeper there. She throws the ball in, even though she's gimpy with like 8,000 stitches in her hand that she has to show constantly, and they're disgusting. Take a look at the starters as they announce you, Lady Cat score from earlier today. Bell, Owens, Bryson Deming, Braden Deming, and Cleveland Harvey for Billings West. For the Hawks, we have the same starters as the first half as well, with Hughes, O'Reilly, Harlan, Hostetler, and McCutcheon. Hawks will start with the ball. Hughes brings it up. McCutcheon with it. Double teamed up top, now up to Hughes, as pushing the press almost to half court is West, and as Hughes drives and kicks it over to Hostetler, he is fouled. So Hughes to inbound it to Harlan. Over to Hughes, back up top to Harlan. To Hughes. He'll take a long three, no good, rebounded by O'Reilly. His turnaround jumper in. Ten points on the night now for O'Reilly. West with it, Owens at the top of the key. Not a lot of movement here by West on their offense. Just kind of isolation for Braden. It's worked in the second quarter. But the Hawks now kind of zoning down on it. And there's a quick jumper, no good, but he'll go to line to shoot two, as Hughes hit the floor hard. Foul's going to be called on Hostetler, his second first team foul. First one up and good by Braden. 12 points on the night now. Second one up and good as well. He's a smooth looking basketball player. He's going to again play tight end, I believe, for the Cats. Hughes with it. And a quick jumper up and good by O'Reilly. 12 points on the night now. Quickly down low to Cleveland. Back up top to Owens. His quick little jumper up and no good. Rebounded by O'Reilly. Passes it too long for Hughes. And a turnover by the Hawks. Still 35-21, 14-point lead, 6:15 to go. Bell with it, swings it over to Bryson. Kicks it over to Bryson again. He'll drive, gets it to Braden, stolen away by Hughes. Nice steal, has McCutcheon. He'll take it himself and tipped out of there. Nice move by Bryson. Blocking it. Owens comes down quick. His little bunny jumper up and no good. Rebounded by O'Reilly. He'll get it up quickly to Hostetler. Almost loses it. Up top to Harlan. His long three, no good. And Harvey gets the rebound and fouled on the reach in by Harlan. Didn't follow his shot. And as Holmquist, the head coach for the Hawks, tells his team, settle down. Just play your game. Don't get too happy to throw up the three-pointer, as both teams seem to be very happy to do. Owens, past the time stripe, 5:30 to go now, 35-21. And just like that, a long three-pointer's no good by Deming. That was Bryson Deming. Up top, the drive by Peretti, down low to Harvey. Tipped around and out of bounds, last touched by Billings West, so it'll go to the Hawks. As head coach for the Hawks wanted an offensive foul on Harvey on the drive, but both teams are doing it, so it's a good no call by the refs. Just let them play down there. Down low, a nice cut by McCutcheon. His floater up and good. Beautiful pass there, and McCutcheon makes it count, 37-21. Back up to a 16-point lead for the Hawks. Down low to Peretti. Back up top to Owen. She'll drive the lane. Kicks it over to Bryson Deming. And what are we going to get called? And a push called on Hostetler, and that's his third. So a big foul there on the Hawks. That's their third team foul. Peretti with it. Over to the corner to Bell. His quick jumper rolls around about eight times and falls. His first 2 points of the night, 37-23 now. Yeah. O'Reilly with it. Hits the screen. Nice move, kicks it out. Harlan now, a long two-pointer, good. Beautiful ball movement by the Hawks. O'Reilly with his second bucket of the night. He's got 7 points. Long three-pointer finally goes for Bell. 5 straight points for Bell for Billings West. And that's their first three-pointer of the contest for Billings West. Before this, they were 0 for 12. And a timeout is called, so we'll take a quick break and give us a chance to thank some of our great sponsors, including Doc and Nelson Funeral Home and Crematory. There is a difference. Heeb's East Main Grocery Store, the best little big store in town. J&V Restaurant Supply and Kitchen Design. Shop like the chef's shop. at J&V Restaurant Supply, Napa Auto Parts in Bozeman, 2616 West Main Street, and Owen House Ace Hardware and Owen House Bike Shop, downtown Bozeman. You can also find them on the interweb at owenhouse.com. Full court press here. And we have a foul. They were bailed out by a foul call. And it's called on Bryson Deming. That's his third. Still four court press. Gets it up to Ash. With the top of the key now to McCutcheon. Hawks set up the offense with just under 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Very quick moving game. 39-26 and a drive. No, the foul will be called on the floor. So Lance got the basket to count, but the foul was called before the drive. And the foul was called on Deming, and that's his fourth. So Deming averaging 15 points a game. He's got four tonight and four fouls, almost thrown away by the Hawks. McCutcheon collects it up at the top of the key, hands it off to Hughes, to Harlan. His turnaround rainbow shot up and no good. It tipped out of bounds. Last touch out of bounds by Kyler Ash for the Hawks. So it will go back over to Billings West. And both teams struggling since half to get any kind of offensive rhythm going. Harvey with it, kicks it over to the corner. Long three-pointer up and no good. That was taken by Prokop. Quickly up to Callahan O'Reilly, blocked from behind, but he's fouled. But nice defense there by Carson Prokop. That's his first and the fourth team foul. So O'Reilly will go to the line to shoot two, but it would have been a wide open layup, but a nice hustle after the missed three-pointer by Prokop to hustle down and almost get the block as O'Reilly went to the line. First one up and good. Second one will count as well. 41-26 now. Point lead. For the Hawks, it's been as many as 18. And we have a reach in on Ash, and that's his third. So Ash trying to get sneaky and got caught with his hand in the cookie jar there. And that's the fourth team foul for the Hawks. Tyson with it, half court, over to Prokop, he'll drive. Kicks it over, tipped out of there by Anderson. Gets it to McCutcheon, almost thrown away, and he'll slow it back down up top. O'Reilly, a long three-pointer, count it. Callahan O'Reilly with his first three of the contest, and it's 44-26, back to an 18-point lead. Biggest, tied for the biggest of the night, I should say, for the Hawks. Down low, and we have Ash with another reach in. Or no, we're going to get it called on Anderson. That was lucky for Ash, as that could have easily been called a reach-in foul on Kyler Ash. Braden Deming, a long three, good. His first three of the contest. Before this, he was 0-for-6. And it's a full timeout, so we will take one as well. We'll take a 30-second break. 2:18 to go here in the third quarter, 44-29. You're watching MTSport.tv.
Napa, locally owned, means hometown pride.
Welcome to Napa Bozeman.
With over 100 years of combined experience behind every counter, we get it right the first time, making it easy for you to conquer the job, on the road, and in the community. Napa know-how means giving back, getting involved, and making our hometown a better place to live. Nationally known, locally owned, Napa Auto Parts.
Welcome back to Bozeman South Gym. 2:18 to go here in the third quarter, 44-29. is our score. Billings West has been down by as many as 18. A big three-point shot there by Braden Deming, his first three-pointer of the night. He's got 16, he averages 17 per contest. So 44-29. Ash with it, almost fouled, now up to O'Reilly. He'll try to dump it down low to Anderson. His turnaround jumper no good, but he'll shoot two. We'll see who this foul was on. There were quite a few Billings West players there. They're gonna call it on Cade Tyson, his second. Mac Anderson to the line. He's got 2 points in the first quarter. Has yet to shoot any free throws. His first one up and good. Second attempt up and good as well. Nails them both, 46-29. 17-point lead now for the Hawks. Prokop with it, looking for Harvey down low. Now gets it up to Tyson. Now kind of stuck in the middle. Gets it to Tyson at the top of the key. Long three-pointer up, in and out, no good. That was by Peretti. And we have a travel called on Hughes. So a turnover on the Hawks. Braden will dribble it up to the top of the key. Tyson with it. Over to Prokop. Back up to Tyson. Long three-pointer by Deming, no good. Rebounded by Harvey, his shot up short, no good. Rebounded in there and it's a jump ball and that will stay with Billings West. So good offensive rebounding there by Billings West. Gives them another chance here. Try to cut into this Hawk lead. And we have a foul called on Harvey. That's his third. Full court press here. Inbounded to O'Reilly. Gets it past half court. Now I'll slow it back down over to McCutcheon. Minute 20 to go. Hughes with it, drives the lane, and we have a foul called on Tyson as he bodied him up. That's his third, so three fouls on Bryson Deming, three fouls on Cleveland Harvey, and three fouls on Cade Tyson. Hughes 1-1 up and good, and that is the seventh team foul, so the Hawks will be going to the line for the rest of the game. That's Hughes' first points since the first quarter, all of them on free throws. He's 5 for 5. Second one up and short. Rebounded by Braden Deming. Over to the right corner. Martin into the game for Billings West. Almost stolen away, but Bell gets it to Owens, has Martin on his right. Will drive to the left, cuts it up and behind the back block by McCutcheon. And are we gonna have a foul called? We are, and he'll shoot two. And they're gonna call Mac Anderson with his second. So to the line is Braden Deming. He's 3 for 3 from the free throw line so far in this contest. First one up and no good. So a big miss there for Billings West. 18, now make it 17 as he sinks his second. 47-30, 17-point lead for the Hawks. Hughes with the runner, no good. Almost gets his own rebound, but rebounded by Braden Deming. So here comes West, 17 points. Deficit, a long three-pointer by Bell, no good. Tipped around and rebounded by West. Martin, Owens with the long three, in and out, no good. Rebounded by Anderson, 31 seconds. O'Reilly with it, over to McCutcheon. They'll call for last shot as there's 25 seconds to go, up by 17 here in the third quarter. No reason to rush it. give West some easy baskets going into the fourth quarter, get their confidence up, and almost stripped away there. Nice defense by Braden Deming. Tipped out of bounds. It'll stay Hawk ball with 15.9 to go. To Hughes with it in the backcourt. Now past half court and stolen away by Braden. Sloppy pass there, and Owens gets it behind the back to Deming, up and good. So Braden Deming continues his scoring rush. 1 second to go. Callahan O'Reilly's two-pointer, no good, and that's the way we will go to the fourth quarter. So the Hawks still with a commanding lead, but West with a nice steal by Deming, up and for two. And that's the way we end the third quarter. 47-32 is your score. We'll take a one-minute break. You're watching MTSport.TV.
Funeral service, we are always incredibly humbled by the family feedback we receive.
You were very patient and went above and beyond our expectations.
It was apparent to our family that this is not just a job to you, but a calling and a mission.
Knowing that my dear husband was cared for so respectfully truly made a difficult time more bearable.
Doc and Nelson Funeral Service, there is a difference.
This live event is brought to you in part by Buckley Law Office, Bozeman Orthodontics, Platinum Property Management, Bridger Bubbles.
Welcome back to Bozeman South Gym. We are at the starting of the fourth quarter, 47-32, 15-point lead for the Hawks, and they will start with the ball. West now 2-for-19 in the game from the three-point line. Hughes drives the lane off the glass and good. They rode him all the way, but he made it. 7 points now for Hughes on the night, 49-32. Back up to a 17-point lead. Owens with it to the corner to Martin. His floater up and good. Caleb Martin, his first 2 points of the contest, so 7:30 to go, 49-34. Slowed down considerably since the first half as the scoring. But the Hawks haven't really needed to put it in that much. Nice move there. Ash off the glass, perfect pass to Hostetler, and he puts it in for two. Quickly down is West, 51-34. Owens at the top of the key. Martin now swings it all the way over to Bell. He drives in down low to Harvey. Nice pass and up and good. So if Harvey with the two, he's got 6 points now. Hughes drives the lane again, and they're going to say it was on the floor before the shot. And if it's on Owens, and that's his third. So third for Owens.